Hello everyone, this is Praneet. In this session, I am going to explain C programming basics. If you see the definition, C program is a general purpose, procedural, compiler based, high level programming language developed in the year 1972 by Dennis Ritchie. So what do you mean by general purpose? It is used for multi purposes. For example, you might have seen general stores in our market where we can have multiple items. So many items are available in that store. Here also, general means C language is used to create so many applications. It is used for multi-purpose. Okay. So, what do you mean by procedural? Everything we need to follow one procedure, a structure while writing the C program. Okay. And compiler based. C is a compiler based programming language. Means compiler means a small software used to convert a high level language to the low level language. Okay. Then what is high level programming language? The language which is in simple English is called high level programming language. Okay. So it was developed in the year 1972 by Dennis Ritchie. So he is the father of C language. So if you see the uses, it is used to create applications like MS Office, Adobe, web browsers, okay, and softwares, compilers, mainly operating systems. Okay, we have operating systems like Windows, Linux, Mac, okay, Android. So many operating systems are there. So all these operating systems, most of the part of the operating systems are developed by using C programming language. Okay, now let us see the definition of a program. What is a program? Set of instructions to perform a task is called program. It's a set of instructions, okay, to do a task is called program. And coming to the types of languages, computer languages are mainly three types: low level, middle level, and high level. Low level is also called as machine level. Okay, the instructions means the program, the instructions are written in ones and zeros. Okay, and coming to the assembly language, the instructions are written in nominics, means it is some abbreviations are used as instructions. Okay, and coming to the high level language, it is similar to the human language, means English language. It is similar to the English language. The examples are C, C++, and Java. Okay, Python, we have so many are there, high level languages. Okay, so this low level language is also called as machine level language. Okay, machine means computer language. So here computer can understand only ones and zeros, that is binary language. Computer can understand only binary language. Okay, so how the binary language looks means ones and zeros. Okay, see here. So this is machine language, that is low level language. How is the data? The instructions are written in ones and zeros, 100, 1011. Okay, so the language looks like a binary language, that is ones and zeros. Assembly language, see here, we use some abbreviations in assembly language. Add a comma b, if you want to delete something, del, tell a comma b. Okay, so we use some abbreviations, these are called as nominic codes. Okay, and coming to the high language, see here, it is very simple. C is equal to a plus b, means we are adding a plus b and storing the value in C. So it is in simple language. Okay, so high level means it is a normal simple English language where user can understand very easily, that is called high level language. Coming to the definition of a compiler, we'll come across these words so many times in the program. Okay, so A compiler is a small software or a computer program which is used to convert a high level language to machine level language. So what computer can understand? Computer can understand only machine language. Okay, that is ones and zeros. Computer can understand only ones and zeros. But how we are writing the program? How we are writing C program? We are writing C program in high level language. So to convert this high level language into low level, that is machine level language, which is helpful? Compiler. Compiler is a small software used to convert a high level language to the machine level language. Why? Because for computer, we are giving instructions in high level. Okay. We are writing the program in high level. Then how to convert high level to low level means by using a compiler. Okay. Why? Because computer can understand only binary language. That's why we need to convert high level to the low level. Now we'll see tokens. Token means a smallest individual unit in a C program, in any programming. Okay. Token means a smallest unit in a programming language is called token. So a unit in a program. Okay. So identifiers, keywords, constants, strings, characters, operators, data types, variables. Okay. Every unit will come under a token. Okay. The smallest unit in a programming language is called token. Okay. Now we'll see one by one. So first one, identifiers. Identifiers are the names given to variables. Identifier refers to the names of variables. Means identifiers are the names given to variables. Okay. Functions, arrays, so on. These are user defined names. Okay. So simply remember, identifiers are the names given to variables. Okay. To create identifiers, we need to follow some rules. Okay. Identifier is a combination of letters and digits. Okay. Letters and digits. The first character must begin with the underscore or character. Okay. Cannot begin with a number. Clear? Both upper and lower case are permitted, but both are not equal. Okay. Why? Because C is a case sensitive language. Capital A and small a, both are treated as different. Capital A is different and small a is different. Okay. No spaces and special symbols are allowed. No spaces and special symbols. Identifier cannot be a keyword. Okay. So you will come to know clearly about identifier. Just wait 2 minutes. See here, what are the valid identifiers and what are the invalid identifiers? So what is the first point we have? It is a combination of letters and digits. Letters are there. Okay. It is a valid. Sub, small letters. You can use capital letters or small letters. Valid. You can use underscore. No special symbols except underscores. Total marks. Okay. It can start with a character. It can start with a character or it can start with a underscore. Okay. So these are the valid identifiers. What are the invalid identifiers? It should not be a keyword. Okay, so written is a keyword here. Written is a keyword. I'll say what is keyword. It's no special symbols. Here we are using dollar. It's a special symbols. No special symbols are allowed except underscore. Okay, this is underscore symbol. Okay. It should not start with a digit. Okay, what is our point? The first letter. What is the first letter? First letter may be a character or underscore, but it should not be a number. Okay. And no space is allowed. No spaces. No space. No space. Okay. So these are the identifier rules. These are user defined names. These are user defined names. You can give any name. Follow these rules and you can give any name. Okay. So these are the identifier rules. What is the definition of the identifier? Identifiers are the names given to variables. Okay. So let us see keywords. In C language, we have 32 keywords. These are the reserved words. Keywords are the reserved words which have a special meaning and used for special purpose only. Okay. So for these keywords, they have a special meaning and it is used for special purpose. For example, break is there. It is used to break, come out from the program. Okay. So char is there, means character. Integer. Okay. So like that we have every keyword have a special meaning and used for special purposes in the programming. Okay. How many keywords are there? We have 32 keywords. Okay. Keywords are the reserved words. We cannot use keyword as a identifier. Okay. So let us see what is an identifier very clearly. A variable is a name. First we'll see the definition of a variable. Okay. So variable is a name given to memory location used to store any data value. Okay. So variable is also called as an identifier. Why? Because what is the definition of the identifier? Identifier are the names given to variable. So variable is also called as an identifier rules. Identifier. So variable rules and identifier rules are same. Why? Because it is also variable is also called as identifier. Then how to declare a variable? First I'll show what is a variable. See here. Suppose marks. Marks is a variable. Marks is a variable where a variable can store any data value. Use variable is a name given to memory location used to store any data value. Okay. So marks is a variable can store any data value. Okay. So this is called variable. X is a variable. Okay. We can store any value. A is a variable. Okay. We can store any data value. Okay. Like we use variables in the maths. Same here also. Okay. So how to create a variable means we need to follow the identifier rules. Based upon the identifier rules, you can create any variable name. Okay. So identifiers are the names given to variables. Before you call it as a variable, it is an identifier. Okay. So declaration of a variable. So before seeing the declaration of a variable, we'll see the data types. In C language, we have mainly three data types: primitive, derived, and user-defined data type. Primitive data types. If you see the primitive data types, integer, character, float, double, and void. Okay. So what are these? What do you mean? Character. What is a character means? The letters A, capital A, small b, capital B, dollar, hash. All these comes under characters. Then what are integer? Integers means the natural numbers we have 5, 17, minus 25, 128. Okay, all these are integer numbers. Then what is float? Float means here we have fraction values 2.5, 0.3. Okay, so these are called float values. Then double. If you see the double, double means its range is longer than float. Longer than float. Okay. So, what are the primitive data types available in C language? Integer, character, float, double, void. Okay. So, mainly we have three data types: primitive, derived, and user-defined data types. Now, we will work on primitive data types. Okay. We will see data types in the next session. So, please subscribe to my channel to get new updates. Thank you. Thank you for watching.